Hello everyone, so welcome to Teach5. So today in this video, let's look at IELTS speaking tips and strategies. Okay, so I'll be giving you a brief introduction about what is IELTS speaking is. First thing, let's go with a brief introduction about what is IELTS speaking. IELTS speaking test key facts, duration between 11 and 14 minutes. Okay, so participants can interview individuals, the test is recorded. So candidates interviewed individually and the test is recorded. So the test consists of three parts, part one, part two, and then part three. This test is same for academics and general. There is no difference. Okay, so 11 to 14 minutes. Sometimes the test may take 45 minutes as well. So why this 45 minutes? Because when an examiner senses that the questions that you have ready-made questions and answers, if he feels that you have learned the questions by heart, the examiner can ask extra many more questions to get the spontaneity from you. Okay, the examiners are well trained to understand whether the questions are ready-made or you're saying it's spontaneous. So be careful not to learn the topics by heart. Say it spontaneously to get a good score. Okay, so let's see what is part one. Part one is one-on-one interview. It's like a conversation, basic conversation. They may ask you simple questions like, what's your name? Where are you from? What are your hobbies? And then what's your favorite food and all that. And part two is a topic round. They give you a topic and ask you to speak on the topic for 2 minutes and then prepare on the topic for 1 minute. And part three is a discussion. So discussion is, so whatever you spoke in part two, so you'll be discussed in part three, right? The test is between one and one, examiner and then you. There won't be any other people who will be sitting around and the test has been recorded, right? So now IELTS speaking test is a easiest task so where you can comfort yourself or be free for yourself so that may see that examiner is your friend and be confident to speak and relax. Don't be restless while talking, don't be tensed. So if you're tensed or restless, you will lose your marks. Be cool and relax and speak whatever the questions the examiner asks. Okay, so this is what part one is. I've just gave you the brief introduction. Part one of the IELTS speaking test lasts between 4 and 5 minutes. The examiner will ask some sample, the examiner will ask some simple getting to know you questions which will help the examiner find out a little about you and help put you at ease. This will be general questions such as about your family, your studies, where you come from, or what your interests are. So part one is basically to make you to be very comfortable with the examiner. He keeps asking you a few questions which are whichever the questions that you are familiar with. Okay, next one, the tips. What are the tips for part one? Okay, so part one, give full relevant answers to the examiner's questions will help get the interview off to a good start. So do not give a short answers. Speak lengthier than the question is asked. So for example, the question is said, what's your name? So please don't say that my name is this. So start expanding your name. So my name is XY and the meaning of my name is XY. And then I would like to be called XY because I am so happy to be called by this particular name. So expand it in a few or 3-4 sentences. Do not give the short responses. So see, avoid giving short, uncommunicative replies. So where are you from? You please don't say that I am from Hyderabad or I am from India. So say the expansive answers. So I am from Horen in Netherlands. Don't stop there, continue. It's about 35 kilometers north of Amsterdam. It's a modern city, but so you can continue with, so whatever the way you want to say it. Okay, so avoid short S, no answers to closed questions. There are questions beginning, have you, do you, is it? So do not start any questions. For example, the question is asked, do you like cake? And then you don't say that, no, I don't like cake. So instead of that, I have a kind of a negative feeling towards cakes. I have a negative understanding about the cakes and my appetite did not support that. So that's how we need to start, instead of starting S, no, which can be answered simply with S or no answers. So do not use those S or no, try to use them in a sentence. Okay, next question. Have you visited any English speaking countries? Yes, do not stop there. So yes, yes, and then students keep stopping it. Continue. So instead of saying yes, use a different word. It's an obvious situation where I really went to a particular place. Okay, yes, I went to England last year and spent 2 weeks seeing the sights. A couple of years ago, I went to New York with my parents and had a great time. Okay, so these are the way that you need to answer in the first part. At least 4 to 5 sentences is to be there. Whatever the question is asked, do you play any sports? No. Don't stop there. Continue. I'm not really interested in. So instead of saying no, you use this sentence, I'm not really interested in playing sports. I like watching sports on TV and I really enjoyed keeping up with the Olympics recently. Okay, these are the few things. Offer examples to help you explain a statement, right? Why are you preparing for IELTS exam? So the question is asked, why are you preparing for IELTS exam? Because I need it for my studies. Don't stop there. I have been offered a place at a university in England to study on an MBA, but I need to show my level of English is good enough. Okay, so this is how you need to expand. And part two, so what is part two? Part two is a long term. So part two of the IELTS speaking test lasts between 3 and 4 minutes, including 1 minute preparation time. The examiner gives you a task card and you have to speak about the subject without interruption for between 1 and 2 minutes. Okay, so there should not be any interruption. So you need to speak continuously between 1 and 2 minutes. Okay, it's a topic round. They give you 1 minute to prepare and the whole test takes 3 to 4 minutes. Okay, so the topic looks like this. The examiner will give you a card like this. Describe a place you have visited that you have fond memories of. And you should say where this was, why you went there, what you did there, and what it was about the place that makes it so memorable. So the topic will be given like this and you have to answer all the bullet points that are given below, you should say. So if you miss out any one of them, you will be getting less score. Try to complete all of them which have been asked in the question paper. This is called cue card. You have to prepare on this for 1 minute. Okay, so let's look at the tips now. Use your 1 minute preparation time wisely and make notes of the points you would like to make. Okay, so the question will help you with the structure of your talk. So the introduction can include the item itself and maybe a brief description. The main body of your talk could describe the situation when you acquired the object and go on to explain when you use it. You can then end with an explanation of why the object is so important. So structure, it's already the logical structure is already there. You just need to add flesh to it. So introduction, and then at last, why you like it. So you just need to conclude with that. Next one is try to avoid giving a very dry, unimaginative introduction such as the object I am going to describe is. Okay, so do not use this sentence. Get your talk off to a memorable start with something on the lines of, if I was about to lose everything, so the object I'm going to talk about, the topic that I'm going to say about, the topic is all about. This is a very dry and unimaginative introduction. To get a good score, start in this manner. If I was about to lose everything and could only say one thing, it would be my. So this could be a very good start. I've got several things that mean a lot to me, but the one that really stands out is my. So this is a very good start. If you are concerned about not having enough to talk about for 1 or 2 minutes, or running out of time before you have finished, the answer is to practice as often as possible. Time yourself and ask a friend for a feedback. So see that 2 minutes of talk, it's not mandatory that you have to complete in 2 minutes, you can take a little extra time. But see that you keep practicing with your friend and ask his constant feedback. So feedback that you need to ask your friend is whether your pronunciation is accurate. Is he able to understand the sentences that you're speaking? Are the sentences in a logical order? Right? Each and every word that you're saying is clear. Or any words that you're eating up. Right? This sort of a feedback you need to get it because the clarity is very important than speaking whatever comes into your mind. Okay, let's see part three, two-way discussion. So part one is one-on-one interview. Part two is a topic round. And part three is a discussion. Whatever you spoke in part two, you will be asked a few of the questions related to part two. Okay, that is what part two is. So two-way discussion. Discussion is between you and then the examiner. No other person would be sitting for the discussion. So in part three of the test, which lasts between 3 to 4 minutes, the examiner will ask you questions linked to the topic in part two. Next, so these are the example questions based on example topics in part two above. It is sometimes argued that local cultures are being destroyed by tourism. Why do you think people might feel this? Okay, so these are the, what benefits do people get from traveling to other countries? Do you think people are becoming too materialistic? To what extent are people's buying habits affected by advertising? So these are the, some of the examples, and let's look at the tips now. If you need time to collect your thoughts, use expressions sparingly, like that's a good question. Well, let me think. It's an obvious discussion. It can be debated. The question can be understood in multiple ways. I don't think so. The idea that you asked may be particularly related to my way of understanding, but I see that it can be differently. It can be differentiated. There can be a differences in my ideas that I speak of. Okay, so these are the ways that you need to start. Do not repeat the question as it is from the question. Instead, use expressions sparingly, like it's a good question to be answered. I don't think so. I am good at this. I have a least experience, but still I'm going to start, or I'm going to explain to you. So this is what the speaking module has to be. Don't forget to avoid short S. So no answers. Try to offer examples to back up a statement. Okay, don't forget to avoid short S, no answers. Okay, try to offer examples to back up a statement. Help make your contributions memorable. Try explaining a point using a short personal anecdote. If the examiner asks the questions that you don't understand, take control of the situation with a question such as, those that appear below responding like this will show evidence of your communication skills. So if the examiner uses a word or phrase that you don't understand, say something like, sorry, but could you explain what you mean by? So you can ask him, if you, the examiner using a certain phrase, and then you just ask him for the explanation and then he clarifies it. But this is also considered as your communication. I haven't come across that word, expression before. Could you explain what you mean? So this is also kind of a communication, and you heard some sentences bold from the blue and you didn't understand that. So could you explain to me, because I've never heard this sentence. So he gently explains you the sentence. If you simply didn't hear something that was asked, respond with, so you are not heard something that examiner said, use a kind of a phrase to ask him once again to repeat the same thing. So say this like this, excuse me, I didn't quite catch that. Could you say that again? I'm sorry, but would you mind repeating that? Okay, so these are the ways that you need to answer. If you want to make sure you have understood what the examiner has asked you, could say, do you mean? When you say, do you mean? Are you asking? Okay, if you want to make sure you have understood what the examiner has asked you, could say, so then you could, do you mean this? Do you mean this way to ask? Or do you mean this the way that I need to answer? So you are most welcome to answer. So we have seen the strategies of speaking different introduction. What is part one? What is part two? And then what is part three? And then we have also seen the time duration for each and every part, and what are the types of questions they ask. And accordingly, we also went in attempting some of the tips, and we have just went through some of the tips to understand. This is just a brief explanation about what is speaking is all about. Please join Teach5 to enter into the topic of speaking more elaboratively to the depths. So please don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. Let us know what would you like us to post in the next video. View our upcoming batches at www.teach5.com or write to us at info@teach5.com. Thank you.